r/AskReddit. Wedding planners if Reddit. What is your best the bride must never know story? If you want to join my giveaway for $500, subscribe and you will be automatically entered. Groom here. I forgot the rings. Sent a groomsman in a taxi. They were handed to the best man with less than a minute to go. Well, my husband told me 3 days before our wedding the venue forgot us. Should not have happened. My entire ability to breath disappeared for a few minutes. Not a wedding planner. But one of the groomsmen absolutely had to work that day and didn't make it to the wedding till like 15 minutes beforehand. Oh yeah. He was the one to walk her down the aisle too. So it was an important thing. People invited themselves last minute to the wedding and had to find them seats. They texted my husband, the groom, at 7 a.m. the day of. Not a wedding planner. But my, now ex, husband showed up an hour and a half late to our wedding. Turns out the best man had gotten so drunk he passed out in a bar and they couldn't find him. I didn't find out until we got the wedding photos back weeks later. Wedding videographer. One time my drive just crapped out. It was early in my business and I had zero software recovery setups. The bride's final wedding video and only copy of the raw footage was on there. Ready to be sent in final delivery via USB. I was in shambles. The only project file was there. The only copy of the raw footage. The only copy of the final video was there. But I did have an unwatermarked version that I'd uploaded to them as a sneak peek. Thank you 4K YouTube downloaded. I was a wedding planner professionally for 2 years and stopped. But recently my sister asked that I plan coordinate her wedding since I had the experience. I hit it off really well with her now husband's brother. We slept together at the after party. And we're both freaking out that my sister and his brother are gonna find out. If so, the holidays should be interesting. Side note. Is that weird? Is he my brother-in-law? Or just my brother-in-law's brother? I'm sure my mother wished this could have applied to them. When my parents got married, my dad had to call her while she was having her hair done to break the news to her that the demolitions in the building beside the reception venue had gone horribly wrong. They sent some debris towards the venue and right through a wall. My mother burst into tears on the spot. Wedding was saved by my grandparents' next door neighbors. Who went fuck it. Party at our place and ordered a shitting of pizza for everyone. Not wedding planner. But. Friend gets married. Maid of honor, not me, forgets to order the bouquet, which is made of silk flowers and it is an unique piece which takes about 2 or 3 weeks to be handcrafted. So. The day of the wedding the maid is searching desperately for the aforementioned piece, almost mission impossible. She finds it. It was from a cancelled wedding that would happen that very day. Edit. Grammar. My cousin's dress got destroyed by accident by the dressmaker the night before the wedding, so we stayed up all night and made her a new one based on her measurements. She found out the day after the wedding after everything was over. One of the bride's guests flipped out in one of those "so when are we getting married?" arguments with her boyfriend at the venue. She left the wedding. Went to his parents' home where their daughter was staying. Took her daughter out of her grandmother's lap while expounding upon their, her child's grandparents, flaws the entire time before driving away. Presumably in the direction of home on the other side of the state. Eventually we were able to convince her to stay at a hotel and bring the daughter back to her grandparents the next day. The bride was quite close with the boyfriend of this madwoman and would absolutely have been distraught by these events. I wish I could say the couple separated after this. But as I worked their wedding too, I just chuck it up to the, evidently, masochistic husband. Ladies. Don't pick that battle. If you genuinely have to ask on such selfish and unfair terms, someone else's wedding. And can't wait to fight till you get home. Then you have other problems that are more important than the wedding you are seeking. At my best friend's wedding we were a little delayed getting introduced to the reception. She thinks it's because they were letting people get seated. Really her father-in-law was running around setting up their cupcakes because the catering company had to fire an employee on the spot for being high. IDK what drug. She still has no idea 2 years later. Not a wedding planner. At my wedding. I forgot to pick up the plates the day before the reception and didn't find out until 1 hour before the ceremony. Let's just say it was a very stressful hour. Working at a hotel. The concierge gave away the wrong wedding cake to a couple from the day before. I was sent 60 miles with the day of the wedding to collect a vegan cake in my old VW Polo. Highlights from the day. Lying to the bride and groom that their cake was in a fridge and a chef had gone home with the keys. Driving with yesterday's wedding cake buckled up on my passenger's seat. Overtaking a police van on the motorway, only slightly speeding, but not getting pulled over. Airborne over the speed bumps in the hotel's mile-long driveway. The big reveal in front of the guests. After driving back with the right cake 2 hours late, we unpacked it without checking first. But blamed the smudged icing on the original delivery as it came from London by car to Scottish countryside. They loved their smudged vegan cake. And had a beautiful wedding. I was gifted a few bottles of wine that I still have. Dozens of weddings, but that was the scariest day in the business. Getting married a week from Saturday. I shouldn't be reading this shit at 3 a.m. Bride and groom choose to do a sand combining thing in their ceremony. Two different colors of sand are poured from separate containers into one container by bride and groom. Representing unity. Etc. They were going to leave for their honeymoon immediately after the ceremony. And arranged for us to hold onto all their gifts and such, including the sand vase, until they returned. Well. It got knocked over in our house and shattered and sand went everywhere. We quickly bought all the same stuff from where they'd gotten it. My mother-in-law was their wedding coordinator. So she knew exactly what to get and where to get it. Looked at photos taken from the ceremony. And duplicated the Unity sand as best we could. We never told them that their Unity sand was actually destroyed and redone by us. Anyway. 3 years later they weren't doing well. And the wife killed the groom and then herself. I guess it was the sand. Just kidding. They're doing great and have 4 kids. On my wedding day. During the reception. A hatchet-wielding gentleman was driving crazy and ended up in a standoff with police just outside the venue. I only realized something was amiss when the incredible DJ offhandedly mentioned that folks leaving would have to turn right and head south out of the parking lot. I don't think the guy died, but he definitely got shot. And every road was shut down around us. But the police knew there was a wedding and kept a path open for us to leave. Not a wedding planner. But the day of my friend's wedding with about half an hour to go. She got an upset stomach from nerves and took it out on the church bathroom. We, the bridesmaids, were milling around outside of the bathroom and when I walked in to check on her, I was assaulted with the most soul-crushing, eye-watering, nostril-burning stench I'd ever encountered. Is it bad? Is it bad? She kept asking. Fixing her hair in the mirror while I silently dry-heaved behind her. I insisted that it wasn't despite the fact that I'm pretty sure what she did was outlawed by the Geneva Convention. And hustled her back into the foyer as quickly as possible. But the ungodly smell lingered so badly that I ended up slapping a homemade out of order. Please use the second floor bathroom sign up for the duration of the wedding. And told her that the janitor had done it because of a leaky pipe. I am a wedding planner who just got married this past month. I messed up the date on my own wedding day. Yup. I do this for a living and I missed that the date was wrong on months of emails. Turns out the bakery had made it a day early, complete with a gold-painted pineapple topper, and had it at the venue before our post-ceremony photos were done. Had I been the coordinator and not this bride one, this never would have happened and two, no way the bride ever would have found out. Was the bridesmaid who was in charge of save the dates, invitations, and anything else involving paper. I designed and handmade their wedding invitations using home devices and DIY hacks. It was pretty complicated to do so on a home printer. I was doing layered printing, so I was very focused on getting the alignments right. About 60 invitation in. I realized that I spelled her name wrong, twice. I have known her for over a decade, and have witnessed many typos made by strangers. I never thought I'd be one of them. I started over and ate the cost of the mistake, fortunately. Pretty marginal. Not the wedding planner. But maid of honor. The bride's grandfather wasn't there for the ceremony. He got lost after insisting he knew the way and didn't need to follow anyone from the hotel and didn't make it in time. He was there for the reception however and the bride didn't notice his absence in the audience during the vows. I wish there were things my wedding planner had kept from me. Instead, she heavily sampled the mixed drinks for the reception pre-wedding and called my mother out for payment while we were taking family photos. But my mom's wedding planner hid the fact that I dropped the top tier of her wedding cake when she and my dad got hitched. I was 7 and they thought me carrying it was a good idea. Friends of friends got a call the night before the wedding from an invited guest. Could he bring his new girlfriend? Okay, sure, adjusted plans. Rearranged tables and ordered another place at a table. Wedding day, those two didn't show up. Former wedding planner here. I managed a 5-star hotel's event department and we had high-end clients that would spend up to and far over a minimum of $150,000 for a single day at our property. Even under the most detailed oriented people, things fall through the cracks. The reality is that most brides on the day are somewhat distracted. A lot of issues that would be gargantuan the day before come across as trivial. Unless it is vital to something the bride will see or hear. Don't say a fucking word. She doesn't need to know that the name card street table 15 are wrong. I was the bride. When the wedding planner dropped the top 2 tiers of my cake and didn't say anything to me, then had the catering department fix it by putting flowers all over the first tier to hide what happened. My sister-in-law thought I knew because after they dropped it, one of them came upstairs where I was getting ready, and when they went back down she said, "It's okay. We have to try to fix it." No one ever came to me. The only reason I knew is that after the wedding she told me they did a nice job of fixing it even though she didn't think it could be fixed. I knew there was something different with the cake but it looked nice, so I was okay with that. After hearing it, I was heated, but all in all, I couldn't even tell. Nice one, planner. Like and subscribe if you want to.